ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
సెకండ్ వన్ ఇస్ సెట్ టు బి యాజ్ ది హెరాయిన్ ఆర్ స్మాక్ ఆర్ డైఎసిటైల్ మార్ఫిన్ ఆర్ బ్రౌన్ షుగర్. దిస్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ది బ్రౌన్ షుగర్. మార్ఫిన్ ఈజ్ ద ఫస్ట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ది ఓపియాయిడ్. Second type of the opioid is heroin or smack or diacetylmorphine or brown sugar. Definitely how that kind of the morphine is gets prepared means morphine is prepared from latex of unripened seed capsule. Latex of unripened seed capsule. Latex means white colored liquid which is dropped from unripened fruit. That is said to be as the latex. అన్రైపెన్ అంటే పండనటువంటి పండు అంటాం. పండనటువంటి పండుని అన్రైపెన్ అంటాం. డెఫినెట్లీ ఫ్రమ్ ది అన్రైపెన్ సీడ్ క్యాప్సల్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ది వైట్ కలర్డ్ లిక్విడ్ విచ్ ఈస్ గెట్స్ రిలీజెస్ దట్ ఈస్ సెట్ టు బి యాజ్ ది లెటెక్స్. ఫ్రమ్ దట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ద లెటెక్స్ దిస్ మార్ఫిన్ ఈస్ గెట్స్ ప్రిపేర్డ్. మార్ఫిన్ ఈజ్ గెట్స్ ప్రిపేర్డ్. Definitely these morphine receptors are present in the CNS and in gastrointestinal tract. Means morphine receptors are present in the brain and spinal cord as well as in the digestive system also. How that kind of the morphine is gets abused? Means either by orally means through the mouth is nothing but orally, or by injection, or in the form of the injection this morphine is gets abused. Again, what is the effect of the drug? It is sedative and painkiller. It is the sedative and painkiller. Sedative and painkiller means sedative nothing but drowsiness. Mattu antaru, mattu. Definitely it is the sedative. Means definitely it causes the drowsiness. By that way, it causes the relief from the pain. Means it is that sedative and painkiller. It is more effective. To persons who are with surgery. Who are undergone to the surgery. Definitely the persons who may be going to be surgery, just before going to be surgery, to cause the drowsiness in the person to relieve from the pain, definitely this kind of the morphine is a lot useful to them. Definitely morphine is always causes the drowsiness and the mattunu kalpistundi. It always causes the drowsiness and finally it may be cause the relief from the pain. That is acts as the anesthetic drug. anesthetic drug. Definitely, morphine is acts as the anesthetic drug, means that causes the drowsiness. By that way, that causes the anesthetic effect in the person. By that way, that causes the relief from the pain. So this is more effective for the persons who may be undergone for the surgery. Next, second one is said to be as the heroin or the smock or the diacetyl morphine or the brown sugar. Definitely this is prepared by acetylation of morphine. Definitely heroin is gets prepared by acetylation of the morphine. Definitely its receptors also present in the CNS and in GI, gastrointestinal tract, that is the digestive system. Heroin receptors also present in the central nervous system, such as the brain and spinal cord, and in the gastrointestinal tract, that is the digestive system, its receptors are present. What is the mode of abuse? Means snorting means forceful inspiration is said to be as the snorting. Definitely heroin is abused by the snorting. What is the use of the heroin? Means it is depressant. It is a depressant substance, means it slows down the body functions, it decreases the body function, it slows down body functions. Definitely body functioning rate decreases by this kind of the heroin abuse. Definitely heroin is a depressant substance. It always decreases rate of body functioning. It always slows down the body functioning rate. These are the opioids. First type of the opioid is the morphine. Second type of the opioid is the heroin or the smock or the diacetyl morphine or the brown sugar. Morphine is always prepared from latex of unripened seed capsule of Papaver somniferum plant. Its receptors are present in the CNS as well as in gastrointestinal tract. It is abused orally or by injection. It is the sedative, means it must be causes the anesthetic effect, that is the drowsiness, and it relieve the person from the pain. This is more effective for the persons who may be undergone the surgery. Second one is the heroin or smock or diacetyl morphine or brown sugar. This is prepared by the acetylation of morphine. Its receptors also present in the central nervous system and gastrointestinal tract. It is abused by the snorting. It is a depressant. It always slows down the body functioning rate. This is the first type of the drug, that is the opioid. Second type of the drugs are the cannabinoids. These cannabinoids are obtained from cannabis sativa. This plant is commonly called as the ganjoy mokka. Cannabis sativa is commonly called as the ganjai mukka. From that, this cannabinoids are gets prepared here. its receptors are present in the brain. Cannabinoid receptors are present in the central nervous system part, that is in brain. Again, this cannabinoids may be abused either by inspiration or by orally or by injection. Definitely, this cannabis sativa leaves, dry leaves, may be used for smoking, that is the inspiration, or it may be orally chewed. Certain persons may be chew that dry leaves of the cannabis sativa, or in the form of the injections also they may be get so abused. This cannabinoids may be abused in the form of the inspiration or by injection or by orally. So definitely cannabinoids, they shows, they shows or increases, they increases cardiovascular activity. What is the meaning of the cardiovascular? Circulatory system. Cardiovascular system means circulatory system. Means they increases the heartbeat rate, they increases the blood supply to the leg muscle. So that only this kind of the cannabinoids always increases heartbeat rate, increases blood pressure, increases blood supply to the various parts of the body. So this cannabinoids mostly shows their effect over the circulatory system, that is the cardiovascular system. So that only athletes commonly abuses this cannabinoid to increase the blood supply to the leg muscle, so to very fastly run to won the game. Whenever the athlete abuses the cannabinoid, definitely heartbeat rate is increases in his body. By that way, blood supply to the leg muscle is gets increases. By that way, energy levels in the leg muscle is also increases. By that way, person shows the excellent performance in the running. By that way, he may be won the game. So means what I am saying here, that cannabinoids are abused by athletes commonly. So that only this kind of the drugs are said to be as the doping drugs. Drugs which are abused by the sports persons, drugs which are abused by the sports persons are said to be as the doping drug. That is nothing but cannabinoids. Cannabinoids are commonly abused by the athletes, they are nothing but sports persons, to increase their heartbeat rate, to increase the activity of the circulatory system, to increase the blood supply to the leg muscle. This athletes very commonly use this kind of the cannabinoids as the drugs here. So that only these drugs are said to be as the doping drug. Then how many types of the cannabinoids are prepared by using various parts of the cannabis sativa? Means four type of the drugs are gets prepared by using the top of the flowers, by using the smooth leaves, by using the resin which is extracted from the cannabis sativa. By using these three type of the substances, various kind of the cannabinoids may be gets prepared. So by using the top of flowers, by using the smooth leaves of cannabis sativa, by using the resin, that is the glue substance which is extracted from cannabis sativa, by using these three type of the substances, definitely four kind of the cannabinoids maybe gets prepared. One is the ganja, second one is the hashish, third one is the marijuana, next one is the charas. What are the four types of the cannabinoids which may be prepared by using the top of the flowers, smooth leaves and resins of cannabis sativa? Means ganja, hashish, marijuana, charas. All this kind of the four type of the cannabinoids have the receptors in the brain. They may be abused by the inspiration, means through the smoking or by chewing or by injection. All these four type of the drugs also increases circulatory system activity, that is the cardiovascular activity. Next to another type of the drugs, that is the third type of the drug. Third type of the drugs, that is said to be as the coca alkaloids or cocaine or coke or crack. So coca alkaloids or cocaine or coke crack, definitely this coca alkaloids are extracted from erythroxylum coca is the plant which is very commonly appears in the South America. It is the South American native plant. It is belongs to South America. It is very commonly appear in the case of the South America. It is the South American native plant from which this coca alkaloids or the cocaine or the coca or the crack is gets prepared. Its receptors are present in nervous system. Its receptors are present in the nervous system. Mode of abuse is snorting, means forceful inspiration is said to be as the snorting. It is a snorted. What is the effect of the coca alkaloid? Means it interfere in dopamine transportation. What is the dopamine? A chemical substance which principally transfer information from one neuron to another neuron. That substance is said to be as the dopamine. Definitely, just assume this is the one neuron, this is the one neuron, again this is the another neuron. Between these two neurons, whatever the chemical substance which is involved in passing of message between these two neurons, whatever the chemical substance which is involved in passing of the message from this neuron to this neuron, that chemical substance is said to be as the neurotransmitter. Neuro means nerve information. Between these two neurons, chemical substance which can transfer the message between these two neurons, whatever the chemical substance which can transfer the message from one neuron to another neuron, that chemical substance is said to be as the neurotransmitter. That neurotransmitter is nothing but dopamine. Dopamine is one chemical substance which principally useful to transfer the information from one neuron to another neuron in central nervous system of the person. In the brain of the person, in the central nervous system of the person, between the two neurons to transfer the message, this dopamine principally useful. Definitely, whenever the person consume, abuse the coca alkaloid or the cocaine or the crack or the coke in overdose, definitely that coca alkaloid interfere in dopamine transportation, in dopamine functioning. This kind of the coca alkaloids interfere or involve, they convert this dopamine as the non-functional. Definitely they may be causes the disturbance to the dopamine functioning. By that way, in low dose it causes euphoria. In low dose, person is look like as joyful or cheerful. Whenever the person consumes this coca alkaloid, he is with increased energy, he is with joyful, he is with full of energy. That condition is said to be as the euphoria. Definitely, person may be feels as with full of energy, person is with cheerful condition, person is with joyful condition, that condition is said to be as the euphoria. Whenever the person abuse coca alkaloids in low dose, whenever the person abuses coca alkaloid in low dose, definitely they causes the euphoria. Otherwise, in high dose, it causes hallucination. Definitely, person is leads to imaginary feelings. In high dose, if the person consume coca alkaloids in high dose, definitely persons may be entered into the imaginary views, into the imaginary feelings. That kind of the nature is said to be as the hallucination. Means what I am saying is that coca alkaloids are the cocaine or coca or crack is extracted from erythroxylum coca plant. Its receptors are present in the nervous system. It is abused by the snorting. Snorting nothing but forceful inspiration is said to be as the snorting. Definitely it interferes in the dopamine transportation. Dopamine nothing but neurotransmitter. The chemical substance which can transfer information from one neuron to another neuron, that chemical substance is said to be as the neurotransmitter. Definitely dopamine is the one type of the neurotransmitter. This coca alkaloid always causes the disturbance to the dopamine functioning. By that way, in low dose, this coca alkaloids causes euphoria feeling. Euphoria means person is feels as he is with joyful, person feels as he is with increased energy, that is said to be as the euphoria. Otherwise, in the high dose, this person may be entered into the imaginary views, that is said to be as the hallucination. These are the three type of the drugs. In addition to these three type of the drugs, other certain type of the drugs also may be used nowadays to treating of certain type of the diseases. So what are the other type of the drugs means? One is the barbiturates. These are commonly called as the sleeping pills. Whenever the person is suffered with insomnia, whenever the person is suffered with insomnia disease, what is the meaning of the insomnia? Sleeplessness condition. Sleepless condition is said to be as the insomnia. The person who may be suffered with a sleepless condition, the disease is said to be as the insomnia. To treat that kind of the disease, barbiturates are more effective. Definitely they causes the sleepness. Whenever the person orally administered a barbiturate tablet, definitely they may be inactivate central nervous system of the person. By that way, sleeping is very commonly appears in the person. That is nothing but this drugs are principally causes the sleeping condition in the person. So that only they are said to be as the sleeping pill. Definitely these are used to treat insomnia disease. Second type of the drugs are amphetamines. Amphetamines are the second type of the drugs. These causes the sleepless. These cause are anti-sleeping tablets. Anti-sleeping pills. They never allows the person to sleep. They always activate the brain of the person. By that way, they always may not allow the sleeping of the person. That is said to be as the anti-sleeping pill. Next, third one is the benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines are the third type of the drugs which may be used for treating of mental depression. Treating of mental depression as well as the insomnia. Definitely benzodiazepines are tranquilizers. What is the meaning of the tranquilizer? They always decreases overactivity of the brain and they causes the peacefulness to the mind. Definitely the persons who are with overthinking, the person who may be with overthinking, to treat that kind of the persons, this benzodiazepines are principally useful. Definitely tranquilizers means they always decreases brain activity. They finally causes the calm and peace to the person. That is said to be as the tranquilizer. They principally decreases brain activity. They causes the calm and peace to the person. Definitely whenever this kind of the tranquilizers are administered, definitely they principally decreases the brain activity. By that way, person is becomes calm and peace. That is the tranquilizer. Next one is the lysergic acid diethyl amide. That is the LSD, lysergic acid diethyl amide is the LSD. This is extracted from Clavicis purpurea. This is the one fungal group. This is the one fungal group. This lysergic acid diethyl amide is extracted or prepared from the Clavicis purpurea, that is the one fungi. Barbiturates, amphetamine, benzodiazepines are collected from the flowering plants. Barbiturates, amphetamine, benzodiazepines are collected from the various flowering plants. But lysergic acid diethyl amide is gets prepared by using the Clavicis purpurea fungi here. Again, what are the plants in our country which are with the hallucination property? What are the plants in India which are with the hallucination property? Means two plants which are present in our country are with the hallucination property. One is the Atropa belladonna. Atropa belladonna, jillad chettu antaru din, jillad chettu, Atropa belladonna. Again datura, these two plants, datura ummetta antaru, these two plants are with the hallucination property which may be commonly available in our country. Atropa belladonna, datura plants, these two are commonly available in our surroundings. These two are with the hallucination property. This is the drugs. Next to continuation topic is the adolescence age and TDA abuse. Next to continuation topic is the adolescence age and TDA abuse. Next continuation topic is adolescence age, TDA abuse. Before going to the TDA abuse, in the case of the adolescence age, at first, what is the adolescence age? What is the importance of the adolescence age? Definitely, when we observe the age between beginning of teenage to beginning of adulthood is said to be as the adolescence. The age between the beginning of teenage, this is also called as the puberty. This is also called as the puberty to beginning of adulthood is said to be as the adolescence. Otherwise, or age between childhood to adulthood is also called as the adolescence age. Definitely, simply we can say age between the 12 to 18 years, or in few cases age between the 12 to 24 years, is collectively called as the adolescence age. Definitely, as per your textbook concerned, age between the 12 to 18 years or age between the 14 years to 24 years, this age is said to be as the adolescence age. Definitely, during this age, physical and mental changes, are very commonly appears in the case of the person. During the puberty age, during the adolescence age, definitely physically several changes are appears in the case of the person, because during the adolescence age, secretion of the hormones, specifically sexual hormone secretion, is increases in the person's body. By that way, physically changes, several changes may be taking place in the person's body. At the same time, nervous system also becomes maturity. Nervous system of the person also undergoes several changes during this age. By that way, maturity of the person is taken place during this kind of the age also. Means several physical and mental changes are appears. At the same time, behavioral and psychological changes also appears during this kind of the age. Definitely during this kind of the adolescence age, physical changes as well as the mental changes are very commonly appear. During this kind of the age, behavioral and psychological changes also appears in the case of the person. So that only, this is the crucial age. This is the crucial age, because during this kind of the age, person is not with the constant mind. During this kind of the age, person is not with the constant feeling. His feelings are gradually changes. His feelings are not under the control. So that only this age group persons are easily attracted towards the TDA abuse. So that only this age is said to be as the vulnerable age. This adolescence age is said to be as the vulnerable age. Vulnerable means more dangerous. During this kind of the age, due to the several physical and mental changes, due to the behavioral and psychological changes, persons are not with the constant mind. Persons' feelings are gradually gets changes. Due to that reason only, this adolescence age group persons are easily attracted towards the TDA abuse. So that only this age is said to be as the vulnerable age. Definitely, during this kind of the age, this age group of persons, why they maybe gets attracted towards the TDA abuse? What are the reasons to easily attract towards the TDA abuse? What are the reasons to easily attract towards that kind of the TDA abuse? What are the reasons to attract towards the TDA abuse by the adolescents age group of persons? What are the reasons to easily attract towards the TDA abuse by adolescents age group of persons? Means one is for curiosity. One reason for curiosity, to know what kind of the feeling may be appears in the person's body whenever they may be abused TDA. That is said to be as the curiosity. Anxiety, telusukovalani oka korikane vanta curiosity. Definitely the curiosity is the one reason for attracting towards the TDA abuse by the adolescent age group person. Second one is the excitement. Third one is the adventure. Fourth one is the experiment. Definitely first reason for attraction of adolescent age group of persons towards TDA abuse is curiosity. Second, excitement. Third, adventure. Fourth, experiment. Definitely adventure means they may be themselves motivated to abuse that kind of the TDA. That is said to be as the adventure. Dhairyam cheyatam antaru. Adventure ante dhairyam cheyatam. Definitely adventure, experiment. They maybe wants to know what is the feeling which is causes in the body by abuse of TDA. Themselves they may be conducting an experiment on their body by abusing the TDA. That is said to be as the experiment. Reasons for attraction of the adolescent age group persons towards the TDA abuse is curiosity, experiment, excitement, adventure. This is the one. Next, another reason for attraction of the adolescent age group persons towards TDA abuse is family unsupportive family and peer pressure is the another reason. Unsupportive families and peer pressure means the persons who may be loses parents during the early childhood, the persons who may be unfortunately loses their parents during childhood, definitely such kind of the person is not with the control. That kind of the person easily attracted towards that kind of the TDA abuse. Such person is said to be as the unsupportive family. Peer pressure. Peer means, what is the meaning of the peer? Same age group of persons. The group of the same age group of persons who are commonly called as the friends are collectively called as the peer. The same age group of persons who are commonly called as the friends, that kind of the persons are said to be as the peer. Definitely friends may be pressured to that kind of the person to easily abuse that TDA. That is the peer pressure, also one reason to attract adolescent age group person towards the TDA abuse. Next reason is to drop from or to overcome academic pressure. To overcome academic pressures also nowadays this kind of the adolescent age group persons attracted towards the TDA. Definitely to overcome that kind of the academic pressures also. Nowadays this adolescent age group persons may be easily attracted towards the TDA abuse. Seventh reason, effect of cinemas or TV or newspapers or internet. Also one reason for attraction of the adolescent age group persons towards the TDA abuse. What are the reasons for attraction of the adolescent age group persons towards the TDA abuse means? One is for curiosity, second excitement, third adventure, fourth experiment, fifth unsupportive families and peer pressure, sixth to overcome the academic pressure, seventh effect of the cinema, television, newspaper, internet also shows their more effect on adolescent age group persons towards to easily attract towards the TDA abuse. These are the reasons for attraction of the adolescent age group persons towards the TDA abuse.